When you define the power elite as somebody else, I regard that as a loser script. I define the power elite as myself and my friends, and that's a winner script. And the way to accomplish things is with a winner script. I define myself as a winner. I define my programs as winnable, and I count on the stupidity of whoever seems to be in power to undo them eventually, because, as I said, every conspiracy has a natural lifespan. Every conspiracy collapsed by double crosses from within or by superior cleverness by rival conspiracies. And stupidity has a definite evolutionary function. I am all for abolishing stupidity, but before it goes, while there's still a lot of it around, we should pay tribute to it.
The strongest conspiracy on the planet is the conspiracy of the stupid.
Yeah.
To prevent schools from educating their children, because they want their children to be as dumb as they are, to prevent television from putting anything intelligent on them as much as possible.
What is it about the human psyche that seems to be drawn towards these conspiracy theories? Is it some love of the unknown, or some idea that there may be forces out there that are controlling our destiny?
Well, I think there are three factors. A, nobody likes to take the blame for their own problems, so they look for somebody else to blame. And if you can find a big enough group, you've explained everything in your life that doesn't work.
That's not the parental conspiracy theory.
Yeah, it's
right?
Not your fault. It's the fault. Yeah, if it's not your fault, your fault are your parents. It's the Jesuits, the Freemasons, the Jews, the Bilderbergers, the Council on Foreign Relations. Of the you got a lot of wide choice to pick who to blame.
Rich white man.
Yeah, as long as you don't have to blame yourself. That's one motive, and another motive is that we are living in very weird times. The world is changing faster and faster, which I think is due to the acceleration of information flow in the modern world. Information is increasing, and the transmission of information is going faster and faster due to internet and the whole computer revolution, which means that most people are living in a world they can't understand. And when people can't understand something, they tend to go for sinister explanations of it. Somebody is manipulating things in a way I don't like. Mm-hmm. That's the way people feel when things change too fast and they can't understand it. And the third reason is, of course, that there are lots of conspiracies around.